How's it going, everyone? It is Pangino here, and in this video we're going to be covering how to monitor your PC stats whilst playing games, or just in general. Whether you're a workstation user, you just use your PC for light browsing, or if you're a gamer, in this video we're going to be covering all of the steps and methods in which I use and recommend to monitor all of the components of your PC. We can monitor how fast your GPU is running, the GPU clocks, GPU memory temperature, memory temperatures of practically all components within inside of your PC, so you can monitor the performance, see what could be causing performance bottlenecks which could be slowing down your games or your PC, and monitoring your temperature so you can keep an eye on everything, and if you do run into any slowdowns or PC issues, how to quickly and easily identify those issues by monitoring your stats of your PC. Everything shown within inside of this video is completely free, simple and easy to set up, and we're going to jump straight on into that now. With all of that and more coming straight after a message from today's video sponsor. Tired of seeing the Activate Windows watermark, built a new PC, or just want to own Windows at a major discount? Head over to WhoKeys to purchase a Windows 10, 11, Home or Pro OEM key at a major discount. Make sure to use code PAN20 for a further 20% off at checkout, where you can use a safe and secure payment method such as PayPal. Once your key is delivered, simply input the key inside of Windows and boom, you're now completely activated and own Windows forever. You'll now have access to all features and no more watermark. Thanks again to WhoKeys for sponsoring today's video. To start off with this video, we're first of all going to be covering in-game overlays to monitor all of the stats whilst you're playing games or are in intensive applications. This will work for any graphics card, whether that be Intel, AMD or Nvidia. My first and primary recommendation is going to be to use RTSS or rivatuner statistics server. You may be familiar with this overlay, you may have seen it in some of my own videos previously or some other videos on YouTube. It's a widely used overlay and I'm going to be showing you how to set that up now, as this is the best option in my opinion. You can monitor practically everything on your PC whilst you're inside of games, set custom overlays on a per game basis, so you can choose to monitor some things on some games, and in a different game you can set up a completely different overlay and it'll switch between them automatically without you having to do anything besides set them up. It's extremely quick, easy and simple to do, and completely free. After this, we'll be showing you how to set up the specific AMD Radeon overlay or Nvidia overlays if you wish to go with the overlays which are built into your graphics control panels. And to close out with this video, we're going to be going over a few different applications which you should have installed to your PC to log your performance whilst you're playing games, using your PC or running through applications. When monitoring your performance statistics with inside of any game or application, on screen now are going to be a few options which you definitely want to keep a close eye on and you should always be monitoring with inside of the options which you select. These are the main components you wish to be monitoring to identify potential issues with performance, overheating or potential bottlenecks, so you can quickly and easily identify any of them if they are being problematic and causing issues with inside of your game. To download and install rivatuner, you want to install it alongside MSI Afterburner, as Afterburner will allow you to unlock all of the monitoring options which we're going to be using. Do a quick Google search for MSI Afterburner or use the link in the description down below. Once on this web page, navigate down to download Afterburner. Once it's finished downloading, select open, then double click on the setup application, select yes, select OK, next, accept the terms, next. When you're brought to the components to select page, you want to ensure that both MSI and rivatuner are both selected, because you want to install both of them, then select next, next and install. When MSI Afterburner opens for the first time, find the settings cog anywhere in the application. Once you find it, click on this. We then need to do a brief bit of setup with inside of here. Head up to the on-screen display tab at the top, go to toggle on-screen display, click in the box next to this. You then need to set up a hotkey. Once you've clicked on the box, press the key on the keyboard you want to have set to turn the overlay on and off. So for me, I'm going to be using slash. Once you've then set that, go down to apply at the bottom. With that selected, we then need to go over to the monitoring tab found up here in the top. Inside of this section, this is going to be all of the options which are available to you, which you can choose to monitor with inside of RTSS. The options you're going to select may be different to mine. You may want more or less options. Anything you want with inside of here to be monitored though, just follow these steps and select it for your PC. We're first of all going to monitor our GPU temperature. It may be labeled as GPU 1, but if it just says GPU, that's fine as well. So select the option, go to the left hand side of the option and ensure that this tick has been selected, then go down to the bottom to show in on-screen display, check this option. That option is then going to be monitored. We're then going to monitor the GPU usage, so make sure the option on the left has been selected to enable this, then select show in on-screen display. Memory usage is going to be our GPU's VRAM usage. This is incredibly important and definitely recommended to monitor, so set up the option by ticking, then show in on-screen display. Core clock is also good to monitor. Memory clock, navigating down to just power, and this will show you the total watts drawn by the GPU itself. Navigating down, and you'll then be able to see your CPU options. This is for every individual CPU core your system has. has. When it comes to CPU temperature, I would just find the option just for CPU temperature, which will show you the temperature of the overall CPU. Select this option, select show in on-screen display, and continue. Another incredibly useful option which I would definitely recommend monitoring on most of the games in which you play where you might be running into FPS issues is your CPU usage. Not just the usage though, we're going to monitor every individual CPU core, because this will then show you the individual usage of each core in your system, which can help you identify a single-threaded CPU core bottleneck. You may be playing a game and running into performance issues, but you're only getting about 20, 30, or even 50% CPU usage, so you may believe that you're not actually CPU bottlenecked. But if you go in and monitor all of your CPU cores, you may find that you have a few individual cores which are completely stuck at 100% usage, which is causing that terrible performance, even though your overall usage is quite small. So for CPU usage, I like to find CPU 1, scroll all the way down until you find the last CPU core usage, holding shift on your keyboard, then clicking on the last option. What we then want to do is navigate down, show in on-screen display, and we're good to go. I also like to monitor my overall CPU usage, CPU power, which will show you the overall chip power draw. RAM usage is definitely worthwhile ticking. This will then bring you down to frame rate and frame time. Enable frame rate, then enable frame time, go down to show in on-screen display, but instead of the normal options, we're going to go to the right-hand side and set this to text and graph. This will then show you that fantastic frame time graph which you can monitor with inside of your games. Once that's then been set up, we can go down to press apply at the bottom, and we've then set up all of the options we wish to monitor. Now if at any point you want to change the order of how these appear in the in-game overlay, say you want your frame rate or frame time to be towards the top of the graph and you want your CPU down lower, you can simply drag the option and drop it on top of something else. Once that's been set, select apply. With the options then selected, we need to navigate to the bottom right hand side, go to the task icon tray, and find rivatuner with inside of here. It should look like a blue monitor with pink text. Once inside of the application, we need to set a few options to ensure that everything is going to work correctly. For this, navigate down to show own statistics, turn this to on. Then head up to the top left hand side. You can choose to start the program with Windows if you wish to do so, but for everyone, we need to ensure that show on screen display has been selected. With that completed, we can then choose to boot into any game you wish to demo this on. So for this demonstration, I've quickly booted up into Overwatch, but again, this should work for practically any game. If you don't see the overlay in the top left-hand side, press that key which you set up for your hotkey earlier on. So for me, that's slash, and as you can see, pressing slash will turn this on and off. Once you've brought up the overlay, you're typically going to not like where the overlay is placed, and for me, the overlay is also way too small, so we can quickly change that. The easiest way to do this is to press Alt and Enter on your keyboard, which should enter your game into windowed mode. Press the Windows key on your keyboard, then bring up RTSS. And this is why we're using windowed mode, because it allows us to use the application over our game, so we can see any changes we make to the overlay live as we make them, so you don't have to keep tabbing in and out. First, we're going to change the size and where the overlay is positioned. The quickest and easiest way to change where the overlay is positioned is by clicking on the arrows around this gray box. So if you want it in the top right hand corner, you click the arrow in the top right. If you want it in the bottom right, click the arrow. Bottom left, click the arrow. Or top left, click the arrow. But it's still too high up. So for this, you can simply either just click the overlay and drag it down, or you can just adjust the X and Y axis using the boxes at the bottom. So if I want to bring this overlay down by 300 pixels, go ahead and put 300, press enter, and as you can now see, this is nicely towards the center right-hand side of my screen. I'm now happy with where the overlay is located, but I want to make it bigger. Go to the on-screen display zoom, drag this up, and once you let go, the on-screen display will get bigger or smaller as you make those changes. You can choose to put a slight shadow behind the overlay by going to on-screen display fill and turning this on, which will just make it a little bit easier to monitor, especially the frame time graph down at the bottom. But again, set this up however you wish to do so. Once that's then done, you can choose to change the rendering mode, which will change the look of the text. If you go to Vector 3D, it's going to give you this look, but if you go to Raster 3D, it will give you this look. Alternatively, if you would like your overlay to look custom like this, where you can see the program in which you are using, alongside your system information, such as the CPU you're using, the power draw, GPU, and other system information, we can actually change the editor to look like this very simply and easily. So if you do wish to switch to this overlay, first of all, what you need to do is simply tab out of your game. Once tabbed out, you'll need to exit out of MSI Afterburner, but keep rivatuner running in the background. If rivatuner also closes, just manually open up Riva by searching for it. Navigate down to the Setup tab at the bottom, go to Plugins at the top, navigate down to Overlay Editor, and ensure the option on the left-hand side of this has been selected to enable this. Once enabled, go to the bottom to Setup. Inside of Setup, navigate over to Layouts at the top, select Load, then select Sample.ovl. Then select open. Once this overlay has then been selected, you can then change a few of the elements within inside of here if you wish to keep things or remove them. You can then head to the top left to layouts, You can then save or save as this layout, name the layout, you can call it anything you wish to do so, then select save, exit out of the editor. This will then bring you back into your game and your overlay should now look like this. Again, you can press the hotkey in which you set up earlier to quickly turn this on or off if you wish to monitor anything live. Just like before, head into RTSS, you can adjust the size of this and the position of this overlay according to where you may want it to be placed. So for me, I now want it in the top left hand corner. I'm going to make it much smaller as this overlay is a lot more detailed and I can make out all the options which I want. And when you're completed, press Alt and Enter once again to enter full screen mode as we no longer have to edit this on the fly, and you can then enjoy your brand new RTSS overlay. If you wish to switch back and forth between the two style of overlays, so a more traditional style of overlay or the more advanced, nicer looking overlay, inside of Rivatuner, go down to Setup, go to Plugins, go to the tick next to Overlay Editor, unselect this tick so it's then been disabled, then select OK. Go back inside of your game, then press the hotkey, and this will bring up the MSI Afterburner style overlay in which you enabled earlier. And for a quick brief overview of this more advanced overlay, in the bottom left hand side we have our overall RAM usage, and we're using 26%. To the right of this we then have another RAM usage, but this is GPU VRAM. You never really want to be using more than 90 to 95% of your GPU VRAM, because you could be running into harsh stuttering issues. Take yourself into the in-game options, and try lowering things such as shadows, textures, and other high demanding options, which will be taking up a lot of VRAM. Above this, we have the graphics card power draw and current temperature. We have 42% on the fans, 160 watts being used, and it's 75 degrees. We then have our GPU overall usage to the left of this. Above this, we then have our CPU stats. I'm using 13% of the CPU, storing 63 watts, and it is 56 degrees. Above this, we have our network upload and download rates. We then have our hard drive read and write. And above this, we then have the game or application stats. So what if you don't want to use RTSS to monitor your games, and you only want to use the inbuilt simple to use overlays which are built into both Nvidia and AMD Radeon graphics cards? Well, this is very simple and easy to do as well. Starting off with those of you running on an AMD Radeon based GPU, ensure that your GPU drivers are up to date and that you do have the control panel software installed for both Nvidia or AMD. Right click on your desktop, navigate down to show more options, and find the AMD Radeon software panel. Start by going to the top right hand side to the settings cog. We then need to navigate up to the top to performance. You then want to ensure that the show metrics overlay has then been enabled. This will then show the overlay in the top right hand side. For those of you that record videos or live stream, if you want the overlay to appear on those, you would also want to select this option. You then want to navigate up to the sampling intervals. This is how often that overlay is going to refresh. You can set this more aggressively if you wish to do so. I personally like to have this set to 0.75. Head over to the preferences tab and ensure that the in-game overlay has then been enabled. With that set up, head up to the performance tab found at the top of the overlay, head to the metrics tab, and this is where we can change how things appear, the size of them, and different shift and O. And go over to the right hand side to tracking. If you want to see your RAM usage, select RAM. If you want to see your CPU usage, select these options. You can also go to the extended drop-down menu for these options, so you can enable or disable individual monitoring statistics. So for the GPU, if we wanted to monitor the GPU utilization, power consumption, but we weren't bothered about the fan speed, we can turn this option off. And as guided earlier on in the video, try to ensure that you are monitoring at least most of these options on screen now, to ensure that you can easily identify any system bottlenecks or temperature issues your system is experiencing. Once you've finished selecting the options which you wish to monitor, we can then head over to the overlay tab to the right of this, where you can then enable show graphs and meters. This can make everything look a lot more prettier. You can quickly see different graphs for all of the different options to see how stable or inconsistent certain options are. This is also where you can change the location of the overlay, so we can go top left, top right, bottom left, or you can even set a custom option where you can then use the X and Y axis sliders to change the position of the overlay. You can also change how many columns appear in the overlay, so you can make the overlay wider, or you can even have all of the options just appear at the top of your screen. And lastly, you can adjust the transparency of the overlay so it doesn't have to be as harsh as this. Lastly, adjust the size. Once you're happy with your AMD overlay, simply go back with inside of your favorite game. If your overlay doesn't appear, the default hotkey to enable or disable this should be Control Shift and O on your keyboard. If it doesn't, select Alt and R on your keyboard, head up to the cog on the top right hand side, then head to hotkeys. On the right hand side, find Toggle Performance Overlay, and again, set this to any key on your keyboard. Exit out, you should then have that overlay set up and being used with inside of your game. But what about for those of you using an Nvidia GeForce graphics card and you want to use the inbuilt overlay for Nvidia? Navigate to the bottom right hand side, find your Nvidia logo, right click, and open up the Nvidia GeForce experience. Inside of the experience, head up to the top right hand side to this, then navigating down to in-game overlay, switching this to the on position, and this will typically be set to Alt and Z on your keyboard, so you can quickly and easily open up the overlay inside of games. Boot into any game you wish to enable the overlay on. For me, that's going to be Overwatch. Then press Alt and Z on your keyboard to bring up the overlay. Head up to the top right hand side to performance. Navigate down to the performance overlay, which is Alt and R. go to the cog for this. Then with inside of here, you then need to set up the performance location. You can have this top left, top right, bottom right, or wherever you wish to have it. I'm going to be setting up in the top right. Once that's then been selected, you'll then have the overlay options. So we can either monitor just latency, which will show you FPS and render latency. If we select FPS, this will just give you an FPS counter in the top right. If we select basic, this will show you your GPU name, FPS, your 99% FPS, render latency, CPU utilization, and GPU utilization. Or if we go down to advanced, it will monitor pretty much everything for you. Press Alt and Z on your keyboard to go back with inside of your game. Once you're inside of the game, you can then see all of the FPS, information, GPU power, voltages, temperatures, and pretty much everything you could want to monitor with inside of it. The only annoying thing about the Nvidia overlay is there isn't that many customizable options, so we won't really be able to tell if our VRAM usage is going too high, which could be causing potential GPU bottlenecks and performance issues. Then at any point, if you want to enable or disable the Nvidia overlay, press Alt and R on your keyboard to quickly turn this on and off. With our in-game or high-demanding application monitoring all set up and good to go, we can now move over to programs in which I would definitely recommend using to monitor practically everything with inside of your PC. Pretty much the be-all and end-all of monitoring everything with inside of your system, from your hard drives, SSDs, temperatures, speeds, pretty much anything you want to monitor can be found in this program for free. So do a quick Google search for hwinfo or hardware info, or use the link in the description down below. On the website, you have a few options available to you. You have the installer, or you have a portable version. So say you want to keep this on a USB stick and you don't want to have to install this to PCs, you can just install it onto the USB stick, plug that USB drive into any PC you want to monitor, and you can do it that way. But I'm going to be going with installer just to install it to this PC. So select free download on your option, go to the drop down menu and just select any of the mirrors. Scroll down and select the version you were going to download earlier, so portable or install. Once that's done, select open. For CPU active clock, this is going to show you each individual CPU core's clock speed, but we're not going to be paying too much attention to this, so exit out. Inside of the main tab, you'll first of all be shown your CPU, motherboard, and GPU. You'll be shown pretty much all information you may need regarding these things, such as TDP, the stepping, so you can see which variant of the CPU you may have, cache information, active cores. You'll also be able to see your motherboard and memory modules. You'll also be able to see your memory timings. And this is great information to have to see if your system is not using XMP profiles, or just to show a more tech-savvy friend any information regarding your system, where they may be able to quickly identify anything which is incredibly low or set too high to help you optimize your system. You can either choose to minimize this any way you want to or exit out. The main things we're going to be looking for is inside of this main page. Head up to the sensors section, click this button, you'll then be given a drop down menu of pretty much everything you could ever want to monitor in your system inside of this application. If you want to find a specific component to monitor, so for me, I'm going to be monitoring my 5900X. This is then going to show me the core voltage, core clocks that I have set, bus clock. I can also go to the drop down menu for the C states with inside of here, memory timings. You can even monitor your page file usage, or CPU temperature of the overall CPU package or individual cores. The minimum this has been drawing since this program has been opened is 70, and the maximum it's spiked to is 84. This will be a great option to monitor if you run into any performance issues, or you're running into thermal throttling because your CPU is too hot. One of the most important statistics with inside of hardware info you should be monitoring for every single user out there on a dedicated GPU, whether it be AMD or Nvidia, is going to be your GPU memory junction temperature. Hovering over this at the bottom will typically tell you where the thermal throttle limit for your GPU memory is. On this AMD GPU, that temperature limit is 105 degrees Celsius. We can see currently the memory chips are running at 70 degrees. The minimum that they have run at since this has been opened is 69, and the maximum is still 70. That's fine, and it means that we are operating within spec. The GPU memory could actually be thermal throttling, causing performance inconsistencies, stutters, and overall lower FPS without you realizing where the problem is actually coming from. I would recommend pretty much every single person watching this video to have this program installed, even if you don't understand most of the things within inside of here. It's a fantastic tool to use and to screen share with someone to help you find and identify any weak points in your system. You can choose to leave the program minimized in the background if you're wanting to log something, or if you want to play a game that is typically problematic for you and you want to come back and look at the data later, or if you don't want to use the program at all, you can simply exit it out, and there you guys have it. If you have enjoyed this video and enjoy learning more things about your PC and how to enhance the performance of it, make sure to check out the two videos on screen now, and I'll see you in the next one.